In this video, we will talk about cell membrane. The cell membrane is also called the plasma membrane or plasmalemma. It makes the outer protective wall of the cell. It maintains the shape and size of the cell. And obviously, any exchange between the inside and outside of the cell happens through the cell membrane only. Now let's talk about its structure. It's very thin and pliable. Its thickness is only about 10 nanometers. The main constituents of the cell membrane are lipids, proteins, and carbohydrates. Lipids make up about 40%, proteins about 55%, and carbohydrates about 5% of the membrane. Now let's talk about each of these components one by one. First, the lipids. The lipids are arranged in two layers, like a sandwich. Thus, they make a lipid bilayer. It mainly has two types of lipids, phospholipids and cholesterol. Along with them, there are other types of lipids as well. Phospholipids are by far the most abundant among them. This is a phospholipid molecule. It has a phosphate head, which is hydrophilic. Means it likes to be with water. And a lipid tail, which is hydrophobic. This means it likes to stay away from water. So the phospholipid molecules arrange themselves in this type of bilayer form, where phosphate groups are on the surface in contact with water, and lipid groups are on the inside, away from water. This is called hydrophobic interaction. An interesting thing about this is that in this arrangement, the phospholipid molecules do not make any strong bonds with each other. These molecules are actually freely moving along the plane of the layer. Thus, the membrane is actually in a liquid state, not the solid one. This is called the fluid mosaic model of the membrane. Now, let's continue with the next lipid, cholesterol. Cholesterol molecules are dissolved in the lipid bilayer. It controls the fluidity of the membrane. At a modest concentration, it decreases the fluidity. Or in simple words, it makes the membrane more rigid. And at high concentrations, it increases the fluidity of the membrane. So these were the lipids. Talking about the permeability of the lipid bilayer, it's semi-permeable. As it's made up of lipids, other lipids and lipid-soluble substances can dissolve in it and thus pass through it. Water and water-soluble substances, as well as large molecules, cannot pass through it. The lipid bilayer makes the backbone of the membrane, to which the proteins and carbohydrates are attached. And that brings us to the protein component of the cell membrane. Proteins are mostly in the form of glycoproteins. Broadly, they are categorized into two types: integral membrane proteins and peripheral membrane proteins. Integral membrane proteins are tightly integrated with the lipid bilayer. And peripheral membrane proteins are loosely attached to lipids or integral membrane proteins. The membrane proteins serve as transport proteins to allow passage of water and water-soluble substance receptors to receive signals as second messengers in intracellular signaling, as enzymes, as adhesion molecules to attach the cell to extracellular metrics or make cell-to-cell contact, form a submembrane cytoskeleton that provides strength and resilience to the membrane, and finally, they may be expressed as antigens. So these were proteins. Now let's see the last component of the cell membrane, carbohydrates. Most of the carbohydrates on the cell membrane are in combination with proteins and lipids in the form of glycoproteins and glycolipids. The carbohydrate portion in these molecules is usually dangling on the outer side of the cell. Along with these are also other carbohydrates attached loosely to the outer surface of the cell. All these carbohydrates cover almost the entire outer surface of the cell. This carbohydrate coating of the cell is called glycocalyx. Functions of the carbohydrates are as follows. Most carbohydrates have a negative charge. So they make the outer surface of the cell electronegative, which repels other negatively charged objects. Second, neighbor cells may get attached to one another through their glycocalyx. They may serve receptor functions. And finally, they may be involved in immune reactions. So this was all about the cell membrane. Now let's have a quick summary. The cell membrane makes the outer wall of the cell. The central lipid bilayer is made up mainly of phospholipids and cholesterol. It's fluidic in nature and permeable to only lipid and lipid-soluble substances. Attached to the lipid bilayer are proteins that serve as transport proteins, receptors, second messengers, enzymes, adhesion molecules, submembrane cytoskeleton, and antigen. And we also have carbohydrates, making the outer coat, called glycocalyx. The carbohydrates give the cell surface a negative charge, help one cell to attach to the other, serve as receptors, and participate in immune functions. That's it for this video. Click here to read the notes on this video at our website. You can also explore our entire animation video library over there. To support us, hit like, leave a nice comment, subscribe, and share the video with all your friends and colleagues. It helps us a lot. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.